facts from Arnold Schwarzenegger. If you don't have it, don't flex it. And statistically, 4 out of 5 men don't have it, but they flex it. I'm here today to lower those statistics and change it to where you do have it and you can flex it. Today, we're gonna be working on the chest. I'll be talking about like the technique for benching, because that's pretty much the alpha chest exercise. To show you how to do that, be like hand grip. And I'll show you different equipment you can use for benching. And then we'll move on to some flies, other presses, and then just totally dominate this chest workout. Let's get to it. Alright, so for the first chest exercise, we're obviously going to start off with bench, a good heavy compound exercise. The first thing we're going to go over is hand positioning on the ball. So, some people, they want to go wide, so other people want to go close, some people go with how the nailing is or something. But if you think about it, pretend to bench just like midair and see where your hands naturally go. That's where you should place it on the ball. You shouldn't force them to go anywhere, just where they naturally go. And that might be, like mine end up closer past the nailing this way. Well, some people might be this way. Other people go, oh, the bodybuilders go really wide, but the big time bodybuilders and powerlifters are like super wide. That's because their build is super wide. Like they're already big as crap, so that's why they're wide. So my hand positioning goes just right about there. And the next thing you want to worry about is keeping the shoulder blades tight the whole time. Like you're trying to pinch a pencil between them and keep it tight the whole time. And then whenever you come up, you don't want to fully extend out like that, because then that'll activate your shoulder muscles and unroll your shoulder blades. So you want to come up to just barely locking your arms out, and then come back down. Just like that. And now, where you want to land with the bar on your chest is just at the bar on your chest, like going across your sternum, just about. So just be right about there. And now, whenever I'm going heavier, I like to go through this whole process to make sure that all my body's tight. It'll help move the weight up easier. So what I'll do is get my hand positioned down, pinch my shoulder blades together, and then I'll put my feet up on the bench and lift my butt up to actually dig my shoulder blades into the bench. Lower butt down, place the feet on the ground, make sure it's all tight and you're pressing. And then with my hand grip, wrap it around the bar. And then you want to act like you're trying to bend the bar in half. And I'll just tighten your neck all in here. Then we'll start to activate the back.
A rebel I be one day. On that track with Gunplay, outcast my whole life, so I decide to spit like Andre. Beef is on my entree, gin and juice, that's Bombay. Driving fast the wrong way, I swear life is like a one way. Pussy on a Sunday, fitness on a Monday. My new crit came with feng shui in my closet's like a runway. Come be my fiance, she fuck me in the Hyundai. My rooftop got a lounge, just sit around and watch her sunbathe. Dinner date for 1K, shopping date for 2K. Bougie ass bitch made me wait the fuck for 2 days. Finally got the two.
Incline bench. It's the same concept as the regular bench, as in it being a good heavy compound exercise. Except now, instead of working the mid chest, we're going to be working the top chest. Or the upper chest, whatever you call it. So, most gyms would normally have like an actual incline bench. But here I have to set it up in the squat rack. Get started. But now for hand grip, it's the same thing as the bench, and really the only difference is your chair is going to be slanted up so then it can activate the upper chest. So now whenever you calm down, you want to come down to where
your upper chest is, and it's just right underneath like your collarbone.
Top off like toupees, drop off to touche. Yeah, my mouth is full of gold and I'm a city boy. And my outfit was in vogue, I'm a pretty boy. Bounce boy, Flocko tell him holla at a nigga G. Riding on my enemies, it's my ghetto symphony. Ne?
Bench and also the regular bench. You want to keep a little arch in your back. You don't want to be punching them like that. You want to have a little arch in your lower back. And the same thing goes with the regular bench.
Alright, next exercise we have is the pec fly machine. This is a good workout to help to tone up your chest, get that squeeze and that stretch in. And it could also work all three parts of your chest, the bottom, mid, and the upper part. It just all depends on your hand positioning. So go take a seat. You also want to have low arch in your lower back. That basically goes for any chest exercise. Just don't over exaggerate it. Just a nice natural arch. So just gripping it regularly is going to work the mid portion of your chest. And now whenever you come up and get that full range up here, you want to act like you're trying to touch your wrists together. You might be able to, but some people might not. You just want to try to touch your wrists together, and that's really going to activate the squeeze in your chest. So, tighten up your shoulder blades, lower arch, come forward, and try to touch your wrists together.
Whipping, witness, my mama as a witness. Bitches, licking, and locking up my swishes. Once she blow my whistle, she know it's dismissal. Spread the news, I'm official. Now hop out my foreign vessel. Before I get aggressive, forget it, already tested.
So on this exercise, you don't necessarily need a heavy weight, just a weight where you can get reps and then feel the burn in your chest. Because that's all the blood rushing in. And that's going to be filling up your chest. Your chest is going to get bigger. It's definitely going to be sore the next morning. All right, so final chest exercise is going to be a close grip dumbbell press. It's a fairly simple exercise. All you need to do, grab 10 dumbbells, get a flat bench, lay down, just smack those dumbbells together. And then whenever you come down, you want to touch the top of the dumbbell to the mid portion of the chest. So that's what you're going to target. And then just come up. Now this exercise is going to be targeting the mid portion of your chest. So that your chest doesn't look wide, and as it gets closer in, it's just flat as all heck. You've got a well-built chest from in out to in.
It's in blood invested till my cardiac's arrested and my 40 ounces empty. Show me what you owe me and a porter house with that. Black magic on the ties, only I. Go rolling down a lonely mile, phony smile. One.
Alright, thanks for watching my chest video. I hope you guys learned something. That's what we're doing here on this whole channel. If you guys want to see anything in the future videos or got questions, make sure to comment below or DM me on Instagram or comment on any of my photos. The social media information is in the description below. And then also, as always, remember to like, subscribe, help spread my channel around, tell your friends. Peace.
Since Rocky spit like Andre, I'm gonna kill him like Big Boy. These rappers is on my entree. He don't like cook.